بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Ready? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. Ma ba'd, fi nazagh al-hadithi kitabullah wa khair al-hadi hadi nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam wa shar al-umuri muhdathatuha kullu muhdathatin bid'ah wa kullu bid'atin dalalah wa kullu dalalatin fi an-nar. Ma ba'd. Alaykum assalam. Do you like to review some of the points? I think we had two times review. I like to review because to remind you some of the points of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, we mentioned one chapter that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was lying in the masjid on his back, putting one leg on the other. Sah? And there is another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbade. So how we can join between these two hadith? One hadith he did, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and another hadith he said don't do this. Do you remember? Alaykum salam. What did we say about this point? And one hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in the masjid, lying on his back and one leg on the other, like this. And another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said don't do this.
Before he might have told not to
do this. Then
he did it.
Okay.
The first one was
Mansukh. Did we mention that this is Mansukh? I did not tell you Mansukh. But what I mentioned that some scholars said, if you are sure that your awra will not be uncovered, your awra will not be exposed, then it is okay. You put one leg on the other. For example, if you wear trouser, for example, you have longi and underwear, you have underwear, long underwear. So you are sure that you are covering your awra. So then no problem to put one leg on the other. But for example, if you are wearing only longi without anything under it, and your longi also it is a little bit tight. So of course, if you lie down on your back and you put one leg on the other, what will happen? Your awra will be exposed. So in this way we join between the two ahadith. Okay? Also we mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ saw a man lying on his stomach, on his face. Then? Okay? He said this is not allowed. This is dajat ahlun nar. This is the way of the people of the hellfire. Wal-iyadu billah. So we should not do this. Tayyib. Also, we mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ said, "Amma ana fala akulu muttaki'a." I don't eat while leaning to one side. Okay? Sitting on a cushion, eating. This is the way of kings, of arrogants. The Prophet ﷺ behaves like the slave. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَأَكُلْ كَمَا يَأْكُلُ الْعَبْدِ وَأَجِزْ كَمَا يَجُسُ الْعَبْدِ. I eat like the slave. And also, I sit like the slave. This is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not fill his stomach of bread. Subhanallah. لَمْ يَشْبَعْ قَطْ مِنَ الْخُبْزِ. Never. Subhanallah. Khubz, how much the bread? 50 fils. 50 fils. Subhanallah. Okay, 5 pieces. And for one piece, big piece, how much here in Kuwait? 20 fils. 20 fils. Subhanallah. And Aisha said, Kan yamur al hilal wal hilal wal hilal. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, we used to see the hilal. Then the next, hilal means the crescent, moon. Then the next one. And the next, it means how many months?
3 months.
We said 2 months, Shabab.
2 months.
Habibi. Kayf, how many months?
2 months.
You don't count?
3 years.
In the bank, you don't count? Habibi. Okay? No, if we say, when Aisha said, radiallahu ta'ala anha, alaykum salam, hilal, wal hilal, wal hilal. So when you see the moon 3 times, it means
2 months.
Because we should count what is in between. Okay? We count what is in between. So subhanAllah, she said, yamur alayna al-hilal, wal-hilal, wal-hilal. Three times the crescent, it means 2 months. And there is no fire at the houses of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It means we don't cook anything. Not only in my house. It doesn't mean, she doesn't mean only the house of Aisha. Also, house of Aisha, Zainab bin Jahsh, Zainab bin Khuzaima, Sauda. Subhanallah. Tayyib. Also, we mentioned he used to yal'aq al-asabi'. He used to lick his fingers after the food. And this is sunnah. Okay, clearly, he used to do this, and also he said, if you, when you finish your food, فَلْيَلْعَقْ أَصَابِعَهُ. You should lick your fingers. طيب. This is, of course, at the end. At the end. Before you wash your hands. Or before you clean your hands by the wipes. Yes?
The plate also.
The plate, يعني, the hadith is here about the fingers. But the plate, of course, if we are eating, especially the rice, okay, because the rice is small pieces, okay, usually, or maybe most of the time, the people ignore and they waste the pieces of rice. And this, of course, is not sunnah. Because this is food. This is food. Subhanallah. Also, he used to eat by through three fingers. طيب أن وكان يجوع كثيرا. Many times he gets hungry صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now if we feel hungry, immediately we eat, or we don't give a chance for ourselves to feel hungry. Why? Because we believe it is haram to feel hungry, and we beat our children if they don't eat their foods. صح. Okay, for example, your son or your daughter, grade 2, grade 3, they go to the school every day from 7 until 2 p.m. Okay, 7 hours, 8 hours. How you will behave if you check the lunchbox of your son or your daughter and you found the food? What is your reaction? Huh? Angry, shouting. Why? Because he did a sin. Why you did not eat your food? Subhanallah. We consider this as a sin. As a major sin. If my son, my daughter, did not eat the food, we shout them. Maybe we beat them. And we threaten them. Tomorrow you have to eat your meal and this and this. صح? And maybe sometimes we call the school. He's a child, he doesn't know how to behave, or he likes only to play. I remember my son was 3 years old, something, 2 years old, 3 years old, something like this. And there was a good doctor, good brother, and maybe some of you know him. Maybe he used to come to Masjid Uthman, Dr. Mulla, I think his name, from Bangladesh. Okay, so I visit him with my son. So he asked me and my wife, what is the problem? So then my wife said, he's not eating the food, okay, except if we go behind him and we force him to eat. Then the doctor started to laugh. Okay, why? Because normally if the child, okay, even the adults, if they feel hungry, they will go to the food, they will eat. Do you think that your son will die because of hunger? If he's hungry, he will go. He'll ask you, oh, dad, I need to eat. But because they are busy and they love to play, خلاص, they ignore or they don't give the priority for the food. Allah musta'an. So the Prophet ﷺ used to be hungry, to get hungry many times. Subhanallah. كان يجوع كثيرا. A lot of times. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he said, نعم الإدام الخل. The best thing or a good thing to dip in is the vinegar. الخل. طيب. And also there is a point, maybe I did not mention this point. Is it allowed to speak and talk and chat while eating? Or it is haram or makruh? This is allowed. If we are eating, we talk. This is allowed. Some people say, if you say, Salaamu alaykum, La salaam ala ta'am. There is no salam while eating. Is it a hadith? No, this is not authentic hadith. Some people believe this is hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is not a hadith. La salam ala ta'am. No, there is salam. You should give salam to your brothers, your sisters. When you enter, you say salam alaykum, and they reply wa alaykum salam. What is the problem, okay? And even, subhanAllah, يعني, this is a good manner when you talk while eating. Because imagine, we are eating, for example, biryani, or chapati, qima, whatever. We are eating and we are silent. You feel bad. He's looking at me, I'm checking how many pieces of sambusa he's eating, and صح? So we should talk when we eat. And the Prophet ﷺ ate the chicken, صح? Dajaj, chicken. And he recommends to eat, to use the olive oil. كُلُوا الزَّيْتْ وَالدَّهِنُوا بِهِ. Eat it. Okay, what is the meaning by saying كُلُوا الزَّيْتْ? Zayt is a liquid, صح? The olive oil. Solid or liquid? Huh? Solid or liquid? Huh? Do you know? Solid? Liquid? Your father is telling you liquid. It is a liquid. Okay. So the liquid we should say, drink it, not eat it. صح? But why did he say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, eat it? Message? It is not working? It is working.
Why?
It is working.
Leave.
It is working. التأخير هذا عشان النت. اي عشان النت. لكن يصل. I think because of the net, it is not strong here. Huh? Slow. Hey. Hey. طيب. Yes, so what is the meaning of كل الزيت? It means use the olive oil and the bread and dip the bread with the olive oil or with something to eat with the olive oil. It is very beneficial, very useful. Zayt. Zayt is zaytun. It is not working, huh? Slow. Okay, stop. Stop. Sef, تكيف شغال? Slow, huh? Started, okay. طيب. So, and the Prophet ﷺ recommends to use the olive oil. Also, we mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ likes to eat what? A dubba. What is the meaning of dubba?
Water.
Potato?
Pumpkin.
Yes, pumpkin. Pumpkin or gourd. طيب. خلاص. I think there is a problem. خلاص. Also, كان يحب the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم الحلوى والعسل. He likes the sweet. To sweeten the food or the sweet food, the sweetened food. Okay, the sugary food. يعني not, he was not putting the sugar, but he likes this, like the honey. Okay, or the watermelon, the melon. Some hadith will come, inshallah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ate in the masjid. So it is allowed to eat in the masjid, but we said we have to take care. يعني don't keep the masjid dirty. And also cooking inside the masjid. The Prophet ﷺ ate the food in the masjid, but cooking inside the masjid, yeah, will cause problem. Maybe sometimes it will be dangerous, because you know some people bring their things inside the masjid and they cook in the masjid. Why? Because they want their special food, dal, al, and chapati and these things. Okay, so maybe he keep the food, okay, on the fire. Then he wants to join the salah. Then a disaster will happen in the masjid. Okay? Subhanallah. Also, we mentioned hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told one of the sahaba, Al-Mughira ibn Shu'bah, okay, cut your mustache. His mustache was long. Okay? The sunnah to cut the mustache or to keep it very, very short. Okay, don't shave by the blade, and also don't keep it long to cover the upper limbs, lips. طيب. يعني now, subhanallah, you notice the shabab, the teenagers. Okay, what do they do? They grow the beard and also the mustache. Growing the beard, okay, this is sunnah. But the mustache? No, this is not sunnah. This is not sunnah, and you see, subhanAllah, you can't know if they are following the sunnah or not by the mustache. Sharb, okay? And also the Prophet ﷺ كانت تعجبه الذراع. He likes which part of the meat of the sheep? The foreleg or the shoulder. The shoulder. The shoulder. And subhanAllah, even the Jews know that the Prophet ﷺ loves this part. And she put the Yahudiya, the Jewish lady, she put the poison more in this place. Why? Because she knows what part the Prophet ﷺ likes. So we tell the Muslims, if the Yahud know what our Prophet ﷺ loves, we don't know what our Prophet ﷺ loves. Now, if you ask the Muslim Ummah, do you know which part of the sheep the Prophet ﷺ likes? I'm sure most of the Muslims don't know. The Yahud know. The Yahud know which part he loves more. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then we mention a thareed. What does it mean, thareed? It is like bread, with bread by soup and meat. This is called a thareed. And do you remember the three things the Prophet ﷺ mentioned? The blessed three things he said. Al baraka. You want to check? Cheating? The Prophet ﷺ said al baraka fi thalath. Blessings in three things. Yalla. Yalla, shabab. Mashallah, mashallah. We should give him a gift. Yalla, inshallah, inshallah, we give you a wife, inshallah. Inshallah. Do you accept this gift? Okay, you don't accept. Pass this gift to anyone. Subhanallah. Tayyib. Good. As-suhur. As-thareed. No. Al-Jama'ah.
Al-Jama'ah, the congregation. The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Barakah fi thalath, the blessing in three things. Al-Thareed, Al-Suhoor, Wal-Jama'ah, the congregation. Subhanallah, يعني, what is the wisdom? Allahu A'lam exactly. But the scholars say, يعني, Subhanallah, because Al-Thareed, it is like very good meal for the body. Proteins, carbohydrates, these things, يعني, lipids, and very good meal for the body. And if you remember, the Prophet ﷺ told us that Aisha liked the thareed in comparison with other kinds of food. Okay? The position of Aisha with other women like thareed with other kinds of food. And at this part, we mentioned that the four perfect women. The four perfect women. Khadija, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Asiya bint Muzahim, the wife of Fir'aun. Maryam bint Umran. Fatima bint Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These are the four perfect women. As it came in the hadith of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also we mentioned that it is the Prophet ﷺ asked some people to give him, to provide him food. And we mentioned it is allowed to ask and to request from others. طيب, the general rule, try to avoid asking others. But if you need, you are very hungry, or you don't have a car, you need somebody to take you to a hospital, to an important place, okay, no problem to ask him. Okay, so it is allowed to ask if you need. طيب. Also, we mentioned the walima for the urs, walima al urs. يعني after the marriage, okay, after ijab qabul, you do a walima, you invite the people. Why? This goes said because subhanAllah, this is one of the main differences between the haram and halal, between the fornication and the halal marriage. Okay, in marriage, I want people to know. Okay, so I invite my friend, maybe my relatives. Okay, of course, without wasting the money and food. And also we mentioned, important point also, if you remember Hadith Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, when he was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was eating something, he was eating the dates or the fresh dates. When Ali radiallahu ta'ala tried to eat, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, stop. فَإِنَّكَ نَاقِهِ. You are in the recovery state. Okay? It is not good for you. So, this tells you, if you remember, the good food is not always good for you. Yeah, for example, I gave you an example, the honey. No doubt, the honey is shifa, is a cure, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. Okay, but you cannot give the honey for everyone. Suppose there is a diabetic person, his blood sugar is not controlled. And we give him honey, yalla, take honey. One spoon, two spoon, you will kill him. Okay, so the good food is not good for all people all the time. As generally, yes, honey is good, olive oil is good, dates is good, no doubt. Okay, but for this state, for Ali radiallahu ta'ala, because he's in a recovery state, the Prophet ﷺ stopped him. Don't eat from this food. Then when another kind of food was provided, he said, yeah, this is good for you. This is good for you. Huh? Something like this, soup, yani, with flour, something like this. Okay? So this is like a revision. I think we need to revise every week, because to refresh your memory, bismillah. طيب. We reach to page number 109. طيب. Hadith 187. We are talking about Shamā'il Muhammadiyyah, describing the criteria of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, attributes of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From Anas radiallahu ta'ala an, who relates from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah the Almighty is pleased with the servant who eats one bite or drinks one sip and gives thanks to him. Allah will be pleased with you. Yeah, even some scholars mentioned that with every time you can say Alhamdulillah. And they mentioned this about in the life of Sheikh bin Baz rahimahullah. You drink, Bismillah, Alhamdulillah. This is one sip, Bismillah, Alhamdulillah. Okay, you repeat Alhamd, you repeat praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "An ya'kul al-akla," the bite, one sip of drink. Okay, but generally saying Bismillah one time at the beginning, this is enough, no doubt. And saying Alhamdulillah at the end, one time is enough. Okay, so only by saying Alhamdulillah, Allah will be pleased with you. And we mentioned last week the full statement, Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha wa razaqani min ghayr hawl minni wa la quwwa. This is the sunnah to say after you finish your food. But for example, if you say Alhamdulillah, it is enough. It is enough. طيب. We'll go to the next chapter, page 110. Chapter on the cup of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They describe even his cup sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because they love him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith 188 from Thabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu relates that Anas showed us a large wooden cup which was lined with metal and said, "O Thabit, this is the cup of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Okay, why Imam Tirmidhi rahimahullah, okay, put this hadith in his book or this chapter to tell us that it is allowed to use the wooden cup even if there is metal. Okay, why the metal? To fix the wood. Because if you keep the wood, it cannot stay, the wood alone. So you need something to fix it. Okay, so the Prophet ﷺ used the wooden cup. Next hadith 189 from Anas radiallahu ta'ala an, who said, "I gave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to drink from this cup. All those things that are drunk, water, nabid, milk, and honey." طيب. If you remember, I explained nabid, صح? Did I explain nabid?
Yes.
Or I explain nabid in Jum'ah halqa? In Jum'ah halqa at the end when I spoke about khamr. You attended the Jum'ah, yes, in the workshop. I think I explained. Okay, what is the meaning of al-Nabid? Okay, very important to understand. Al-Nabid, okay, from the word yambud. What does it mean yambud? To throw something. Okay, I have something, I throw. Yambud, okay? So, at that time, if they like to drink something sweet, yeah, now we have the juice. Okay, we have the Pepsi and Miranda, these things, okay? At their time, if they like to drink something sweet, what do? They throw the dates or the dry grapes, raisin, huh? Zabib, it is called the Zabib, okay? Why? Because after 3 hours, 4 hours, or maybe after one day, the water will be sweet. Okay, so the Prophet ﷺ used to drink nabid the first day, the second day. After the third day, he will not drink. After the third day, he will not drink. Why? They say because subhanallah, if you keep the dates inside the water, with heat and humidity, what will happen? Fermentation, صح? Fermentation, so the alcohol percentage will increase day and day. So what will happen? To a certain level, this drink will become khamr. Okay, will become khamr. So the point here, I mentioned this point many times. Alcohol is not khamr, not necessary is khamr. Alcohol can not necessary is khamr. Why? Because if the percentage of alcohol in the drink, for example, 0.01%, it is not khamr, it will not cause intoxication. And if you remember, there was a big news before maybe 10 years or something, okay, people drinking beer. Okay, they say alcohol free, but some of them know there is alcohol. Okay, the point is, alcohol is not, we cannot say alcohol is haram or not haram. If the percentage of alcohol inside this drink can cause intoxication, then it is haram. Okay? Because if the percentage is 0.1, the question, can this cause intoxication or not? Okay? So if it is causing, khalas, we say this is khamr. If it is not causing any problem, okay, drink it. Drink it, no problem. طيب. So we should not say, yeah, I mean, we should not translate khamr as alcohol. I believe this is wrong. To replace the word khamr, I mean, in the Arabic books, you replace the Arabic, or if you are translating a book, you remove the word khamr and you put alcohol, this is wrong. Because khamr is not alcohol. Okay, khamr has alcohol, okay, but what is the percentage? This is a different issue. Yes?
Sometimes some food are cooked with too many wines. So, just so this person is, that can we use the food?
Okay, if the food is cooked with wine, what is wine? Wine is alcohol or khamr? Khamr, khalas, don't use it. Don't use it. Because it is not allowed to use khamr. Okay, but my point is, khamr is not alcohol. Khamr, no, yani, sorry, alcohol not necessarily always is khamr. It depends on the percentage. Depends on the percentage. طيب. Even the very high percentage of alcohol, yeah, for example, if alcohol 95%, okay, this will kill the person. It will not cause you intoxication, it will kill you. So we cannot say this is khamr. Yeah, usually we use it sometimes in the lab. It is called, I think, it is called glacial alcohol. The percentage more than 90%. This will kill the person. Okay, but some people, shaitan, they know how to make the khamr. طيب. Allah musta'an. Somebody is asking, what is the book? The book is called Shamā'il Muhammadiyyah of Imam Tirmidhi. Shamā'il Muhammadiyyah. طيب. Where is our point? So, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I said, I gave the nabid, milk, honey, by this wooden, by this cup. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one hadith, he forbade to use a dubba' as a container. Okay? The hadith authentic. But later, he said, yes, it is okay allowed. Why? The scholars say, because at the beginning, yani, people used to ferment the things and to make khamr by these containers made of pumpkin. So at the beginning, the Prophet said, don't use it. Khalas, he wants to make it clear. Later, when the issue was clear for them, khalas, what is haram is khamr, pumpkin is halal. Okay? Fermentation after three days, not allowed. Khalas. Now, the Prophet ﷺ made it clear for them, khamr is haram, but using the pumpkin is halal. Even the container, by the wooden container or by metal, like copper, this is allowed. So the point is khamr. Khamr is haram. Tayyib? Chapter, yes. Okay, when you hold the cup, okay, we should use the right hand if we are going to drink. Okay, but for example, if you cannot, the containers or the pot is big, okay, use the left hand. Why? Because you cannot. But mainly we should drink with our right hand. Use the right hand. طيب. Any question?
Can I ask it before we just less amount of, if something causes like intoxication in higher amounts, you cannot use it in less amount.
Okay. Abu Abdullah mentioned this is hadith. Maskara kathiruhu faqaliluhu haram or famil kaf min haram. You mean this? I think you mean this hadith. Okay. If the big amount causing intoxication, then the little amount is haram. Okay. What is the problem here? The hadith mentioned the amount, not the percentage. There is a difference between the percentage and the amount. You got the point?
Yeah, okay, so the alcohol percentage is...
Yes, I'm talking about the percentage. This hadith talks about the amount. But I'm talking about the percentage. For example, I have a small bottle. What is the percentage of alcohol in this bottle? 0.1. Okay, if the same kind of drink, but in a big bottle, 1 liter, and the same percentage of alcohol, 0.1. If I drink 1 liter of this drink, can it cause intoxication? No, khalas, this is halal. Why? Because this percentage cannot cause intoxication. The small amount or the big amount. So I'm talking about the percentage, but that hadith talks about the amount. What is the meaning of the hadith? For example, if the percentage of alcohol in this bottle, small bottle, how many? 200 milliliter. The percentage of alcohol, 20%. Anyone experience with alcohol? With khamar? What is the good percentage of khamar? Khalas, no need to tell. No need. My friend told me maybe the maximum is 60%. In Ireland, I don't know why in Ireland they like a khamar. Huh? Too much. 30? He told me in Ireland they love khamar. Is it true? Why? Maybe the most consumption of khamar there in Ireland?
No,
UK. In UK? Okay, the same. Okay, let's say the percentage is 15% of alcohol in this bottle. So, if I drink, it will not cause anything. But if I drink 1 liter of 15%, 1.5, no doubt it will cause me drunk. I'll be drunk. Then we should say drinking small bottle is haram. If somebody say, but it will not cause anything. Only it will make my body warm. Say, no, this is haram. Why it is haram? Because if you drink 3 bottles or 4 bottles, it will cause a problem. Say, but I'm not drinking. No, no, no. Then we tell them the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, if the big amount cause drunk, then the small amount will be haram. Clear?
Sure. You know, can we also say that in fruits, there are a percentage of alcohol, so if you eat 100 apples, you're
going to
get drunk.
Sorry?
In fruits, like apples, there's a percentage of natural alcohol.
Yes, yes.
If you ate 100 apples, you would never get drunk.
Yes. Yes, there are, as brother said, the natural things. As I mentioned, the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ used to throw the dates. This is something natural. There is alcohol. And maybe I mentioned, when my friend working in Kuwait Institute for Scientific Research, he's a doctor, chemistry. He said, we did an experiment. When we put the dates inside the water, after 24 hours, there was alcohol. And after also 48 hours, the alcohol was 10 times. So there was alcohol from something natural. Okay. So my point is, don't be sensitive if there is any percentage of alcohol. But also, don't be careless about alcohol. Okay? It doesn't mean I'm calling people, yalla, drink alcohol. No, you should be careful. But we should be, accurate about what is halal and what is haram. Okay, and don't say to people, no, this is haram. If there is alcohol, haram. Also, we should be very careful. Don't tell people about things haram and they are not haram. Okay? Chapter 30, page 110. Chapter on the fruits eaten by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Abdullah ibn Ja'far.
radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to eat cucumber with fresh dates. This is a mixture of, from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, people now, they have special mixture, huh? When they go to the fruits or the juice, okay, put avocado with apple, with madrishino. So the mixture of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the cucumber with dates, okay? But the hadith, al-qitha'ah, okay, what's the cucumber? Cucumber, in Arabic we call it? Khiyar. Khiyar. But in Arabic, al-qitha'ah. فَادْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ يُنْبِتْ لَنَا مِنْ بَقْلِهَا وَقِثَّاءِ وَفُومِهَا وَعَدَسِهَا وَبَصَلِهَا. القثاء, it is mentioned in the Quran. Okay, subhanallah, before 25 years it was available, this food in Kuwait. Okay, now I don't see it. Okay, it is longer than the cucumber and the color is lighter. It is not dark green like the cucumber. It is lighter, and also it has lines. It has lines. Okay, next time bring. Or we go with you. we call it, in Kuwaiti language, we call it lutruh. Lutruh. Okay? Lutruh, what is the name in Bengali? Shosha? Okay, good name. Good name. Tayyib. Okay, so the Prophet said, mix this. Yani, subhanallah, why? As some scholars mentioned, because the date, the nature of dates, little bit hot. Yani, you feel it, maybe you feel some acidity with the dates. If you eat the dates, maybe you feel some acidity. So it is a little bit burning. While the cucumber is good for the acidity. Yani even the doctors recommend the cucumber. If you have acidity, if you are suffering from acidity, okay, take the cucumber, it's good for the acidity. So subhanAllah, this is barid, but this is hard. This is hot, yani, with a burning sensation, and this is cooling your feeling. طيب. So this is the mixture of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next page, hadith 191 from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, who said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to eat melon with fresh dates. Tayyib, melon with fresh dates. In Arabic it is called al-battikh. Al-battikh, it is watermelon. Watermelon, not melon, okay? So watermelon with dates. So this is another mixture. One mixture, cucumber with dates. The second mixture, watermelon with dates. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, yani, what can we understand from these hadith? No problem to enjoy the food. Okay? But not all the time. Okay? We don't like both extremes, okay? Like the Sufi or some Sufi, no, we should not eat the meat, we should not enjoy the food. The Prophet ﷺ, like in this hadith, he ate what he likes. He likes the sweet, something sweet, okay? Like the dates, like the honey, no problem. And also the other extreme, okay? We fill our stomach all the time, every time we like what we eat what we like, okay, and we feel angry if the food is not perfect. Also, this is not the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eat what is available. And also, don't criticize the food. Don't criticize the food. The Prophet sallallahu Abu Huraira, hadith Bukhari. Abu Huraira said, ma'aba Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ta'aman ghat in kariyahu in ahabahu akala wa in kariyahu taraka. The Prophet ﷺ never criticized the food. If he likes, he will eat. If he doesn't like, he will not eat. As simple as that. Khalas. Don't make a disaster at home if you don't like the food.
what is this? I don't like this. Many times I told you don't. Okay. خلاص, if you like, eat. If you don't like, go and sleep. مَا السَّلَامَة. Or go to and sit in the masjid. But shouting and maybe and cursing your wife. And, this is not the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next hadith, 192. From Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who said, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam eat together musk melon and dates. Okay? Musk melon with dates. Okay? This is called al-khirbiz. In Arabic, al-khirbiz. And this is what is called, in Kuwait, we call it al-batikh. Or in Arabic, it is called shammam. Shammam. Shammam is melon? Sweet melon. Mush. Okay? So, in Kuwaiti, raggi, watermelon. Raggi. Raggi. Okay? Al-batikh, اللي هو الشمام. طيب, the melon. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam like this with dates. So melon, watermelon with dates, or cucumber with dates. Something to cool your stomach and acidity, and something the opposite. Okay. So this is good, and this is life. Okay. Even at home, with your children, maybe sometimes you are strict, and your wife loose and relax. Or the opposite, if you notice your wife strict, you should relax and you should be soft. But if both of you strict with the children, they will hate you. Okay? Or both of you soft and relax, flexible, both of you, what will happen? Okay? You'll spoil your children. Okay, so of course, what do I mean by strict? I mean, يعني, clear rules. You follow the rules. Okay, and relax. I don't mean that you do the haram, but as you know, at home, okay, the halal things, يعني, the normal life. Maybe you, يعني, for example, okay, you told your children you have to sleep the weekdays 9 p.m. Okay. خلاص, you should 9 p.m. Okay, but this is not Quran, and this is not a hadith. Okay, so maybe the mother say, okay, no problem, today 9:30, something like this. I don't mean, okay, today you pray and tomorrow you don't pray. No, you have to pray every day. You have to avoid music every day. We cannot say in the weekend the music is halal. No, in Jum'ah you pray only one prayer, which is Jum'ah. No, I mean the halal and haram. خلاص, always halal and haram. But about the normal things, the kinds of food and the time to go to bed, something like this. طيب, next hadith, we mentioned this hadith, 193. We'll go to the next page, 112. Yes. From Abu Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala an, who reported that when the people saw the first fruit of the season of plantation, they brought it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When he received it, he said, O Allah, bless us in our fruits, and bless us in our measure, and bless us in our mud. Mud, mud.
This means mud.
It means mud. This is an Arabic word. What does it mean of mud? Mud? Both, yes, both hands. Is it an English word?
It's called mud.
Mud is an English word?
Yeah, but
mud.
Soil.
Yeah, no, this is Arabic word. No, here it is an Arabic word. Mud. They mean mud, an Arabic mud. Mud, the amount of both hands. Because mud is something different, the clay and mud, the sand. No. They mean mud, both of your hands. طيب, اللهم بارك لنا في صاعنا وفي مدنا. Okay. Oh Allah, Ibrahim was the servant. Which language is it? Days, huh? Very old, huh? Shakespeare, هذه, huh? Huh? Because they and was your servant, your friend, Your friend, he means Khalil. Okay? Khalil, and also, some brothers asked me, I think, before 3 weeks, also our Prophet Muhammad is Khalilullah. Okay? There is a common, maybe we don't say it is a mistake. Okay? But the correct thing that Ibrahim and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, both of them are Khalilullah. Khalilullah. Khalil, I mean, the general meaning of Khalil, it is something stronger than friend. X man, he is my friend. Okay, or he is my colleague at work. Khalas, I meet him only at work. No, the other one, he is my friend. So I meet him in the masjid, for example. Every day I meet him in the halqa. No. Why person? He is my Khalil. What does it mean that my Khalil? So I travel with him to Umrah. I visit his house. He visits my house. Okay, I know his family. He knows my family. So Khalil, like from the word yatakhallal, his love, okay, inside my heart. Okay, so the level of khulla is a higher level than friendship. Okay? It is also a higher level than normal love. So Ibrahim is Khalilullah, and also our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Khalilullah. And there is a common sentence, Ibrahim is Khalilullah, wa Muhammad Habibullah. Sah? This is common. Sufis? But some of the others, they think this, sah? Sah? Some ustads. Huh? We have problems with some stuff, huh? Okay. Is it in the book? Is it written in the book? Alhamdulillah. طيب. So our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also Khalilullah. But it is not mentioned in the Quran, it is mentioned in the Hadith Bukhari. أَلَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ اتَّخَذَنِي خَلِيلًا كَمَا اتَّخَذَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Allah is taking me as a Khalil, as if he took our Prophet Ibrahim as a Khalil. So both of them Khalil. خليل الله سبحانه وتعالى. طيب. And your رسول, messenger. And I am your servant. And your رسول. He made supplication, Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, to you for the showering of blessings upon Mecca. Okay? We mentioned this in Saturday's halqa, last week. Okay? When we mentioned the story of Ibrahim and Ismail and Hajar. Yes. When he left Ibrahim, Ismail and Hajar, he made this dua. Okay? And I am making supplication to you for, what is written here? No. It should be Medina. Huh? It should be Medina. Oh, should be Medina. The Prophet ﷺ made dua for Medina. So this is, huh? Arabic also Mecca? Huh? Ibrahim made a dua for Mecca. And now Prophet Muhammad ﷺ for Medina. Okay? You have the Arabic version?
Yeah.
In Arabic also it is written Mecca? لا لا نقول المدينة يس مدينة يس نو المدينة in the Arabic version المدينة and also as a meaning the Prophet ﷺ made dua for المدينة Ibrahim made dua for مكة عليه السلام and our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم for المدينة okay. But I think the one who translated did not understand. Because it is confusing him in Arabic. Okay, because in Arabic, Allahumma inna Ibrahima, abduka wa khaliluka wa nabiyuka wa inni abduka wa nabiyuka wa innahu da'aka li makka wa inni ad'uka lil madina bimithli ma da'aka bihi li makka wa mithlahu ma'a. Okay, and I am making supplication to you for Medina and the like of it here it refers Mecca. In addition, okay, so double of Mecca. Oh Allah, I'm making dua for Medina, okay, and also something like the dua for Mecca. So double. So Medina had, so Mecca had one dua and Medina double. And like Mecca. طيب. Then he would then call to him the youngest child and give him these fruits. طيب. Okay, why do they bring the first thing of their fruits? Because the Prophet ﷺ is a blessed man. Okay? يعني, there are certain things we can understand from the ahadith, it is only for our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, like some hadith, inshallah, will come. Okay, and like this hadith, like this hadith. طيب, يعني, can we do the same thing now? Yeah, for example, we go to Imam Masjid at the beginning of the first fruit in our farm. I take the first fruit from my farm. I go to Imam Masjid. Okay. No, some scholars say this is only for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay. But generally, yes, we can make dua when we see our fruits. We can make dua, no problem. We can make dua, no problem. طيب. يعني طيب. Next hadith, Rubay' ibn Mu'awid, is not authentic hadith. And also 195 and 196, not authentic hadith. We go to the next chapter, 31. Chapter on the description of the things that the Messenger of Allah drank. From Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, who said, the drink most liked by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was that which was sweet and cold. Sweet and cold. Okay. This hadith for our brother Saeed, not here today, huh?
Second time.
The whole chapter, okay? So no problem if we like the sweet drinks. So do we have problem with sugar? Okay, we don't have, the sugar is not our enemy. Okay, but the problem if you exceed your limit, the excessive usage of sugar, this is very bad. Okay, and also another thing here, it is a natural sugar, not like our sugar now, the white sugar. They call it the white poison. Allah musta'an. طيب. So the Prophet ﷺ likes to drink what is sweet and cold. It's very nice to drink something cold. Okay, but now we see some people in the morning drink warm water. Don't drink cold water. What is the problem with cold water? The Prophet ﷺ likes the cold. طيب. Allah musta'an. We'll not say it is haram, of course, but the Prophet ﷺ used to drink the cold drinks. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He likes it. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Next hadith from Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, who said, Khalid ibn Walid and I both accompanied the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the house of Maymuna. Who is Maymuna? Wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Khalid ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. She served milk in a vessel. طيب. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drank from it. I was on his right and Khalid ibn Walid on his left. طيب. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the right of drinking now is yours. Okay? If you so wish, you could give your right to Khalid. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, I will give no one preference from your leftovers. Imagine, the Prophet ﷺ drank from the Laban, and on his right, Abdullah ibn Abbas, young. What is the age of Abdullah ibn Abbas at that time? Maybe 12 years old, 13, 9, 10, something like this. What is the age of Khalid Walid? No doubt, he was older than Abdullah ibn Abbas, because he, when he was a non-Muslim, he was one of the famous people in Mecca to fight. A famous fighter, رضي الله تعالى عنه. So he said, this is your right. Do you like to compromise for Khalid? He said, no, never. This is from your mouth. I will drink. طيب. رضي الله تعالى. After that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whenever Allah feeds one something, this supplication should be recited. O Allah, grant us blessing in it and feed us something better than it. And whenever Allah gives someone milk to drink, one should say, O Allah, grant us blessing in it and increase it for us. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is nothing that serves both as food and water except milk. طيب. Nice hadith. Now, the first point here, as a manner of the gathering. Now you have guests. Okay? Like Duwaniya, like you have a U shape. They are sitting. So from where you should serve? From the right side. From the right side. Okay? Even the children are on the right side. You should start from the right. طيب. But now there is hadith. Like this hadith. Who drank the first one? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet, and he was middle. Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah said there is another narration that in a different situation, okay? Hadith Sahih Muslim said, "Istasqa Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam istasqa. What does it mean istasqa? He ordered something to drink. So they gave him at the beginning. Then he started from his right. So Sheikh Albani said, mainly we should start from the right side to save the food and drink. But if someone asked for a drink, we start with him, then we start from his right. Yeah, for example, I'm sitting, and 3-4 people on my right, 3-4 people on my left. I ask Abu Abdullah, please, a cup of water. Okay? So, this case, should he start from the right side, or he should start from the one who ordered? The one who ordered. Okay? So, I start drink, then from my right. This is what the Prophet ﷺ did. Maymuna, his wife, served him, because he wants the water. Or the Laban. Then he gave the one who is his right. Because what did Sheikh Al-Albani say, rahimahullah? Say, because some people did not concentrate on this word of the hadith, istasqa. They say, you'll find some scholars say, if there is an old man or if there is a scholar, so you start with the scholar. Don't start from the right side. Of course, this is one opinion. This is one opinion, and the other opinion, you start from the right. Why we should start from the kids and our children? We start from the respected man, the scholar, or the, for example, if there is a minister or something like this. Okay? No, we should try to start from the right side. Even if they are children, then we go through the others. If somebody asks for water or for the milk, we start from the one who ordered, then you start from his right. His right. This is the first point here. The second point, okay, this is specific for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What do I mean? I mean, Abdullah ibn Abbas wants to drink after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? Because his saliva. He put his mouth in this container, on this cup. Maybe you'll find some books, they say the issue is التبرك بالصالحين, to get blessings from pious people. And they will mention this hadith. And also they will mention other hadith. Look, how the Sahaba were trying to take the blessing from the saliva of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sweat, his things. Okay, so it means we can take from our shuyukh, from our scholars, from our imam. But this is not allowed. And this is wrong evidence and proof for them. Yes, it is authentic hadith. طيب, it is authentic hadith. But it is wrong understanding. Because, be careful. Sometimes people quote for you an authentic hadith, but not in the suitable place. So, we should tell them, do you know a single hadith that the companions went to Abu Bakr to take from his saliva or from his sweat or his shoes? Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, Aisha, Salama, Maymuna, Habiba, nothing. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. Okay, now the question. Why did not the Sahaba, why did not the companions do that? Because it is not Sunnah. And because they know this is only for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now those people who go to their shuyukh, wallahi, I'm taking the blessing from his shoes, from his hand. Okay? When you shake hand with them, they try to take the blessing from your hand. Why? Because you are mullah, you have beard. Okay? And they try to take the blessing both hands. Sah? They try it. I think if they have a chance, they will cut your hand. Huh? So see, okay? They believe you are a blessed man and you everything is blessed. No, this is wrong. The companions did not do this with the Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, radiallahu ta'ala, and whom. The blessings only with the Prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam, like Isa, alayhi salam, like Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, his sweat, his saliva, his sputum, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, okay, his body. Okay, but after that, no. No. What is blessed? The blessed things mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah. The Quran is blessed. Ma Zamzam, the water of Zamzam, blessed. Okay, olive oil, Shajara Mubarakah, from a blessed tree. Okay? So this, we have certain things mentioned by the Quran and Sunnah. طيب. Next chapter, enough ولا? Sorry? Yes, sorry, I forgot also. Yes. In this dua, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you notice, he differentiates between milk and other kinds of food. About milk, what you should say, Allahumma barik lana fi warzuqna khayran min. Oh Allah, bless this food and give us what is better than it. But if you drink laban, if you drink milk, you should say, Allah, oh Allah, bless us with this milk and give us more. Why? Because nothing is better than the milk. At the end, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is nothing that saves both as food and water except milk. What is the meaning? It means, subhanallah, yani, the milk is a full meal. And that's why, subhanallah, the new baby, okay, if you have a new baby and you feed him, not you, of course, your wife, okay, if she breastfeed him only from her breast, okay, he will be strong. It is enough for him. No need to give him water, no need him to give food for two years, enough. So the milk, I mean the laban, is enough as a food. You don't need to add anything with it. The Prophet ﷺ said, nothing, you can live, nothing can be instead of milk, nothing can be instead of food except the milk. The milk is enough. The milk is enough, subhanAllah. It is a full meal, the milk. And as I said, this is very clear for the kids. Okay? So if you have a new baby, some people say, okay, give him this kind of drink and give him that, put this mixture. Please don't do this. If his mother can breastfeed him, khalas. This is enough and even more than enough. And this is enough for yani, what are the benefits, okay, for breastfeeding? It is good for you or as a father and for the mother and also for the kid and also for the society. It is good for the father. Why? Save money. You save money, okay, because subhanallah, the milk of children is expensive, so you save money. Okay, how it is good for the baby? It is healthy and no need to sterile. It is already sterile, naturally sterile. Do you need to make it hot? Directly from the breast to the mouth, alhamdulillah. And mashallah, it is full of immunity. It is full of the immunity, what is called the first 2-3 days, I think they call it the sebum. It is full of antibodies. Sorry. It is full of antibodies. So it is very good to feed, to breastfeed the child the first days. First day, second, third. So it is very good. Okay? So no need to sterile, and also full of nutrients for him. How it is good for the mother? Okay? Breastfeeding. It is headache. Okay, why? Because she cannot sleep 2 hours, continuous 2 hours. Every 2 hours she wakes up. Okay, but it is very good for her. How? Abu Fatma. Yes?
Breast cancer,
Ahmadi, Allah alam. Maybe it is good for to avoid breast cancer or to lower the percentage. Allah alam. Ajr. Inshallah. It is good. I mean, medically, it is good for the mother to bring the uterus to its original place quickly. Because what does happen in pregnancy? The uterus gets bigger and bigger, صح? And it needs time to go back to its normal place, normal size. So what can help the mother? The breastfeeding. Yes, it is painful, but it will help the mother to bring the uterus to its normal size. And also, subhanAllah, breastfeeding the baby will strengthen the relationship between the mother and the child. Holding the baby all the time. Okay, subhanAllah. Yeah, they say the child can feel his mother. But if you are giving the artificial milk, the baby doesn't know who's the mother. The father or the maid, the grandmother. Okay, subhanAllah. So it will make a good relationship with the mother. So subhanAllah, breastfeeding is very good for the father, the mother, the child. Also the community. Why? Because of the immunity, it means less diseases. Allahumma ista'an. I think I should stop here. Jazakumullah khair.